Oops, we got disconnected. I accidentally hit stop recording, so I had to publish that last one. So, yeah. Basically, I was saying that I saw the big picture of why businesses do all the paperwork themselves and make sure it's just right, as though they were doing their own paperwork for themselves, of which they had already accomplished. So they make very well sure that they do all, fill in all the blanks, and then they just give it to you to sign. Because they know for a fact what succeeds. And what succeeds is the fact that they had their eyes all over the paperwork before it was sent in. So they could see every invisible loophole that might pop itself up and be able to take care of it. Otherwise, something might happen and your customer would be very dissatisfied. And pretty much the name of the game out in the business world is you want to satisfy your customers. Because that is the evidence of virtuosity. Of virtue. That's the essence of virtue. The essence of virtue is to... if you're going to trade with people, if you're going to go into trade with people, it has to be an equal... it has to be equal on both sides. It has to be a fair trade. Fully disclosed. Full disclosure. Plus, doing it that way too, you get to learn the loopholes of the system. And you get to find out where it is and all the different places that the banks want to evade the process. So you being the self-employed, you get all that knowledge given straight to yourself. Otherwise, as if the customer was to prepare their own paperwork, and send it in, then only the customer sees any response from the bank. Unless, of course, the customer has a teaching packet where the customer would bring all their responses to the self-employed secured party creditor. I could see how that could happen. Now, just getting back to the reason why I made this vid is because I had fearful envy at the secure party creditor who was on the video. But then I realized, whoa, wait a minute. Actually, I'm doing exactly what I want to do. Because I don't want to be pressured into doing other people's paperwork. In other words, I do things in my own way and at my own pace. So, if I ever do someone's paperwork, then, I would do it in my own way. I would do it in such a way that it wasn't binding on my time, That's probably how I would do it. I would do it in such a way so that there could be no room for finger pointing or blame in case I made a mistake. I would remove all obstacles in my way before I ventured. And if I found myself sucked in by accident, then I would have enough motivation within myself to immediately stop. And to tell the customer the tell the customer the truth. Say, I thought I was ready for this, but I wasn't. I made a mistake. Because it's only one customer. But, because I've employed that principle in another situation of life. I know the benefit of just telling people, hey, look, I thought I could have you live at my house as a homeless person, as homeless people, but on second thought, I see that I can't, I'm not ready right now. So I just told the people the truth. Or the person told the person the truth. Instead of just kicking them out and saying, well, I can't do this. Well, why? They want to know why. Well, my honest answer is, I thought I was ready to do something like this, but I realize I'm not. And so all the blame gets put on me. There's no blame on them. There's no finger pointing at them saying, get out of here, you homeless guy. You know, that type of atmosphere. Just pure honesty. Truthfulness. So, therefore, I've pretty much found in all of my life that pure truth is the best way to go. Because it's the least resistant I've found that works for me. It's a path of least resistance for me. That way I don't have to memorize any stories. And I could just, you know, imagine what that can be like. Let alone trying to remember them. Oh my word. I see instantly how that's just a big trap to get into when we start lying and making up stories. It's like, oh my God. How does someone live a life like that? Holy shit. Then I could see where they finally just get to the point where they don't really care what they say anymore then, because they can't remember all the stories that they put together in order to make something make sense in their life. So they just say, well, fuck it. I'll just be known as a crazy that says anything at any time. And I could see how people could live lives like that. It's like they just do whatever they say, whatever they want, lie, cheat, steal, doesn't matter to them. As long as they don't, and if they get caught, if they can just say anything they can and get weasel their way out of it, then it's people. And it brings peace to the situation. Well, better to have peace then, huh? Oh my God. Peaceful ends by way of unvirtuous gain. These are interesting words I'm speaking. I'm learning how to speak Vedas and not feel attached. Wow. So yeah, I was able to speak freely and clearly without having to try to make a point. So there is a good thing to just going anywhere you want, any direction you want, not having to make a point. There is a good thing in doing that. So I can kind of see this must be how women communicate. They just keep following the road wherever it leads to. Maybe that's why they're pretty good at following the path of least resistance. Women seem to be more sensitive in that area. They just start talking and chattering, and wherever the subject leads, they just keep going. They're not pressured into trying to maintain one point. It's like they don't. It's like they feel the tension in their body automatically at the most sensitive level, and they say to themselves, I don't want to feel tense like this. So I'll just change the subject, start talking about something different that makes me feel good. Ah, so I can see how that works. Wow. As I'm doing it right now, I'm noticing the relaxation and tension in my body as I just be prepared to go in any direction with my conversation. I got my eyes closed. I'm not worried about what I'm going to say. I'm just say whatever's there. Pretty good way to be. So actually, I'm kind of feeling good just being here saying nothing right now, looking at the video, trying to be as general as I can. I think that's what it is again, leading down the road of generality, because I touched on that a few videos back. Just recently. So I've probably made 50 videos here in the last 2 weeks, so within the last 50 videos, it's in there. That's a lot of teaching. You'll find that there's free informative value in all my videos that I make. For you, for those of you that like to dig for treasure, oh man, you get all kinds of nuggets in my videos. But, you know, if you're just starting out in private maritime law, then all the nuggets don't stand out. They don't stand out. Because the conscience in certain people has not been developed in that level of thinking yet. So I think that's all I need to say in this video. Okay, so here I am, Secure Part Creator, and I just do whatever I want. I got a claim a lien on this house, so I don't have to pay anything. I don't need money. I don't need food, because Catholic Community Services and Food Bank, St. Vincent de Paul, they provide me food free. If I want to go that route again, I took myself off it this month because I'm concentrated on getting my ATM card, practicing my faith here. And yep, I just had a siren sound. So I don't want to get lost into that thought, so I just want to learn to flow with it. Don't get lost in it. Just observe it. It's just a sound. It's a manufactured sound of Mother Nature. See, my next level in universal law is to live without definitions. To let go of definitions and meanings. this is another attachment level in life. Like for me, in the Illuminati knowledge and my secure party status, I just do whatever I want all day. You know, I don't have to pay for anything. Although I have made my first private payments on something, and I'm getting it enforced as we speak. But, I haven't had to pay for anything. It's all been supplied to me for the past 2 years. I haven't had to pay for nothing. Well, the past year and so. And if I need to go on the internet, I just went to the library. So, if I needed wood to keep warm, I just went to the Catholic Community Services. They provide free wood. If I need toothpaste and showers, I can use the community showers through Catholic Community Services. So, I went all the way down to the bottom for anybody who has a house. If you don't have a house, then that's just where you're at. You don't have a house. So, thus, you're going to probably need Federal Reserve debt notes to pay for your bills. Because you have to have a house in order to live, and you'd probably be renting. So that's why most secure party creditors on YouTube are self-employed, because they learn to so they might as well, with their habits that they have, they might as well make paper money showing other people how to become secure party creditors, so that they can have paper money so they can at least pay rent and keep the power on. So, otherwise, the utility company will condemn the property. So if you're a landlord and you have renters, then the power utility has to be paid all the time. But for me, I don't. I own this house, free and clear. It's all paid for. You can thank my affidavit of debt validation and Obama's debt canceling mortgage program for that one. So. But I filled out all the paperwork. I did my own taxes, everything. I've always done my own taxes every year. So, and if there's something I didn't know how to do, then I just let the tax preparer do my taxes, and then I would just copy what they did for the next year. In other words, it was an easy way to educate myself. If there's something I didn't know how to do, I just... Or I could go to the free questions office. I did that 1 year. Went there and asked them, how do I do a rental? How do I do taxes for a rental house? They showed me what to fill out, And so I said, oh, shoot, that's easy. I can do that. It's just a matter of copying what they did, getting the forms they got. It's easy. But I did lose my rental house, though, to foreclosure, because I didn't have a lien in. I had a UCC-1, but that's not a lien. So I lost that house by way of court battles. I went to court to try to save it, and I had to travel across the state. So, from one state to another, from Oregon to Washington. So, but, yeah. So, seeing how I've gone through everything that a man can go through that would come against this house, I've stood it all, withstood everything, every corner. From the banks, to the state tax, to the IRS tax, to... county property tax, to plumbing and electrical inspectors from the city to try to condemn the property when I purposely quit paying my power bill and they cut the power. So the city has to go in and find out why the power was cut. So they left their cards at the door, and all they did was get the email off their cards and send them both emails and say, you know, everything's safe and sound here. And just as I bought the house, I decided to take myself off the grid. If you have any questions, please contact your attorney. Here's my lien number, registered in the Secretary of State's office. And, and I didn't hear anything back from them. And that's exactly what they, they haven't bothered me since. And I know we both have an understanding, so. So yeah, I faced everything you could possibly face, so. I can live without money. I can live off rainwater. I can I made a rocket stove in the backyard. One of these days I'll film it. But so I can boil my own water. If you can boil water, you're good to go. That's all you need. Hot water is all you need. And, of course, being able to dry stuff with your fire, too. I learned how to set my rocket stove up so that I could dry stuff. Dry my socks. Socks are the most important. Socks and underwear. And next in line would be shirts. But, I learned how to make my own candles. Learned how to make my own wicks out of newspaper. And... I just melted wax into empty cans of beans and centered the paper wick in the middle of it and let the wax dry. That way I could bring my candles inside if I need light. And I put my candles underneath a clay flower pot, because I learned how to make clay flower pot heaters on YouTube. And I used fireproof brick and built up a little fireplace around my clay flower pot that I placed my candle underneath. And I put my socks on top of that, and it heated my socks every night. So, you know, I'd wear my socks dirty for about a week, and then I'd wash them, wear my socks dirty for a week. I'd have two pair of socks, two pair of shoes, and I'd take out the insoles, and I'd make them all nice and dry as I could, and I'd switch shoes periodically throughout the day, but switch socks, heat my socks up, you know, heat my take the insoles out of the shoes, heat those up, heat the shoe up, keep the shoe dry so I could keep my feet from catching any funguses. So I suppose we'll end it right there. All right, talk to you later.